And Basu Ghosh, who is known as a great singer that Mahaprabhu really loved, he was leading the kirtan. And Gadadhar Pandit, Srimati Radharani herself, and Bhattrasur Pandit. Bhattrasur Pandit is a very elevated eternal associate of Mahaprabhu. He was famous as a dancer. He could dance non-stop for 3 days, continuously, you dance. And by seeing him dance, now you don't hear this very often. You can look through the scriptures, Chaitanya Bhagavat, Chaitanya Chaitamita, Chaitanya Mangal, Marayagupta's Kacha, and all those books. But whenever, you don't see this very often, that Mahaprabhu is personally singing, leading the kirtan. You don't really see that much. But whenever Bhakrasur Pandit would dance, Mahaprabhu would be so enlivened that Mahaprabhu would start to lead the kirtan. He would sing. And Bhakrasur Pandit would go totally crazy, mad in ecstatic love of Godhead, dancing. And you tell the Lord, my Lord, you should get 10,000 Gandharvas to sing. And I'll just dance and dance and dance and dance. Mahaprabhu would reply to him, saying, my dear Bhakrasur Pandit, you're like one of my wings. I wish I had one more other wing so I could fly. He loved him so much. He accepted Bhakrasur Pandit like one of his wings. He needed one more. He didn't compare Bhakrasur with anyone. That much Mahaprabhu loved him. So they all came here and began to dance and chant. Hearing the sound of the mridanga, Govinda must have been an expert mridanga player that attracted Mahaprabhu's attention. So he was playing the mridanga so expertly. Hearing the mridanga sound, all the local people all gathered here. And they saw Mahaprabhu dancing, they saw Bhaktisar Pandit dancing, Gadadhar Pandit dancing. The only thing you could hear is the holy name, and nothing else could be heard. And the Matajis, they kept on giving Unudvan. You want to try? Try? The Lord was so pleased. He was exhibiting his transcendental ecstasy. Exalted devotees were singing and dancing. The Matajis were giving Unudvani. It created such a transcendental ecstasy in this area. Then the Lord, in the mood of Krishna as a young cowherd boy, he said, let us walk on the side of this pond. Let us sleep under these trees. And let us eat a lot of milk sweets. Let us eat a lot of yogurt and butter. Understanding the mood of the Lord, all the local dhambasis, they brought a lot of yogurt, a lot of butter, and the Lord ate and he fed everybody very nicely. Devotees were happy. They had a very fired up, energetic, transcendental kirtan, danced, Now they had refreshments, yogurt and butter. Then, as the Lord was eating, after he finished eating, relaxed a little bit, then one gopa came, cowherd friend of Krishna. His name was Bhima Gopa. He came. And he said, my mother, Syama Gaulina, she'd be so happy if you could come to the house. She's actually inviting you. She wants to feed you. Please, my Lord, please accept my request. Please come to our house with all the devotees. He begged the Lord with so much sincerity, the Lord decided to go to his house. Lord went to their house. Oh, the Mataji was so happy. The Lord himself has finally come to her house. She made everyone sit properly, folded hands. He addressed Mahaprabhu as Pandit Dada. Dada means elder brother. Pandit means scholarly person. So, like, oh, elder brother, who's a Pandit? So he said, oh, Pandit Dada, how are you? The Lord said, fine, fine, I'm okay. How's your mother? Fine, fine, my mother is good. Bhima Gopa accepted Mahaprabhu as his uncle because Syama Gaulina Mataji, she accepted Mother Sachi as a sister. That's why she addressed Mahaprabhu as Dada, elder brother. They sat and there also Mahaprabhu took a lot of milk sweets, He was in the mood of Gopa. The Lord ate very peacefully. He was very happy. Then the story what Janani Vasprabhu said, he went on the back of the house. So if the house was here, back of the house was the pond. And he was looking at the pond. Nice pond. And the devotees informed him that you can hardly use any water from this pond. Even the cows don't drink the water. They just make the sound. They also make the sound, hamma, hamma. Okay, this is not a cow sound. But cow was making the sound. And when Mahaprabhu heard the cows don't drink water because of the crocodile, the Lord decided to deliver the crocodile. I mean, 4 yugas is a long time. And Markandeya Rishi lived for such a long time. And this crocodile lived such a long time. Old, can't do anything. So Lord decided to deliver the crocodile. Told the devotees to begin the kirtan. The kirtan was so attractive, crocodile came out of the pond. And he touched the lotus feet of Mahaprabhu. Soon as he touched the lotus feet of Mahaprabhu, immediately he got his original form, Devasisa. The Lord was very surprised. The Lord knows everything. You know, he acted. Oh. Can you imagine this microphone I just touched and it becomes something else? And so this crocodile in front of everybody became a Devasisu, demigod child. Asked him, what's going on? What happened to you? How did you get this body? And he explained the whole story, how he cut the Sikha of Durga Samuni in Vrindavan. That's pretty serious offense. Cutting somebody else's sadhu's Sikha like Durga Samuni. Durga Samuni is very furious. You know, this is one says you want to stay away from, don't want to make him upset, because he gets upset very fast. One Maharaj was telling a story about Durga Samani. Of course, this is a known story, but there are different versions of the story of Durga Samani. But this version of the story of Durga Samani. You know how Radharani cooks something for Durga Samani? So this Maharaj said, in a different way, he said, Durga Samani came, and Durga Samani was very angry. She was hungry. So when Durga Samani wants something, Bali give it. Don't resist. So he came and he asked, Radharani was there, the small girls were there, gopis were there. He says, you know, give me something to eat, I'm hungry. So one story said Radharani cooked something. The other story, this Maharaj said, Radharani picked up some dirt from the Vrindavan, right there. She picked up the dirt and she made it into a small laddu. And she gave it to Durga Samani. And Durga Samani was thinking, what on earth are you doing? I'm hungry. And you're giving me a laddu made out of mud? And Radharani was like, the other gopis, understanding how glorious Radharani is, what she could do, they all encouraged Durga Samani. Take it. This is out of this world. Whatever comes out of Radharani's hand, it's so good, just take it. These are young children. So Durga Samani, seeing the conviction of the gopi girls, how convinced they are that whatever Radharani gives, even if it's a piece of mud, it's the most tastiest thing in the universe. So, little reluctant, Durga Samani took that laddu made out of mud directly from Radharani's hand and he bit. As soon as Durga Samani bit, Durga Samani was like, wow! What is this? I have never ever tasted a laddu so beautiful, so tasty. Give me one more! So like this, Durga Samani took few laddus from Radharani. Durga Samani was so fortunate. Then he gives the blessings. Durga Samani. He's a Brahman, right? Brahman's business is take prasad and he gives blessings. So, ate very nicely. The laddus given by, offered by Srimati Radharani. Whatever you cook, will be nectar. Imagine, now Durga Samani is giving the blessing back to Radharani. Whatever you give, whatever you cook, will be nectar. Whoever eats your food will not get any disease. Will have a long life, will be very healthy and strong. So when this news spread, Yashoda Maya thought, Radharani should cook for Krishna. So this is a very interesting story because sometimes the devotees perform the activities of doing certain service, just like Sandalya Muni. Sandalya Muni was the Kula Guru of Nanda Maharaj. Now when the Guru comes, you touch the feet of the Guru. You do the washing to lotus feet of the Guru. So, Guru's lotus feet washed. Nanda Maharaj takes it. Now it's time for Krishna to take. Sandalya Muni knows this is Krishna, this is the Supreme Lord. He is going to take my charanamrita. It's feeling so uncomfortable, very uncomfortable. But he also knows that he must do his service. So Nanda Maharaj takes, Krishna takes. And just by seeing how happy Krishna is to take the charanamrita, Sandhya Muli is thinking, okay, this is my service. This is my service. He gives. Do Durvasa Muni just ate the mud laddu, and this is the best laddu ever in, you know, he has ever. Now he has a lot of disciples, he travels a lot. That's one good thing about being a sadhu, you know. You travel, eat nice prasad. Durvasa Muni, he has tasted a lot of good food. Never tasted food like this. Now he's giving blessings. So, Durvasa Muni Sikha cut. Obviously, he gets very furious. I curse you to be a crocodile for so long. One thing is okay, 2 years, 1 year, is, God, 4 yugas is a lot. It's a bit too much. So he begs, he understands his mistakes, he apologizes, you know, follow the feet of the rishi. Please, my Lord, there has to be some way. Seeing the pathetic condition of this Devasishu, said, okay, in the beginning of Kali Yuga, Srimad Mahaprabhu would appear. When you hear the kirtan of the Lord, you come out, you touch the lotus feet of the Lord, get your body back. So that very transcendental pastime took place here. Now during the parikrama, when the devotees come here, they roll on the ground. This is one place, they all roll on the ground. I will request the Nani Vasu to say why the devotees roll on the ground here, whether we should roll on the ground, and how beneficial it is to roll on the ground. You want to hear from Janani Vasu?
Yeah.
Okay. So I'll request from Janani Vasu to speak about.
So this is the process for performing prakram. It's like when you enter into the temple, you take your shoes off, you leave it outside. So when you enter the dharma, you put your ego, false ego, outside. You enter in your pure ego as a servant of Krishna. Immediately you should roll on the ground, cover your body with dust. Then afterwards you shouldn't brush it off. You shouldn't get dust on your body and then take it off, because my body is dusty. But this is very pure. Very pure dust. So, the dust of the dharma is very, very wonderful because it carries it touched the lotus feet of all the devotees, what speak of Rama Rama the world. So it's like saffron dust particles mentioned in the Srimad Bhagavatam. The devotees, because they're always with Krishna, they're always at the lotus feet of Krishna, they pick the dust from Krishna's lotus feet. And when you associate with devotees, especially when you hear them, this dust, saffron dust, enters into their ears and into their hearts and completely purifies them. And it awakens their dormant Krishna consciousness immediately. Prabhupada said, up until that time, you are forgetful of being forgetful of Krishna, but immediately, when that dust enters into one's ears, from the lips of a pure devotee, the chanting of Hare Krishna, Krishna chanting, the dust enters in the ears, it goes into the heart, and immediately awakens one to Krishna consciousness. He said, although previously we were asleep to Krishna consciousness, but this is the power of the dust of the holy dharma, and it comes out in the form of in the form of the holy name, or the words from the pure devotees of Krishna. But this is actually why we stress purity so much. In Prabhupada's books, always stressing purity, 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 becoming pure devotee. So what is the purpose of this purity? It's not that, you know, I want to become a pure devotee, I want to become purified. The idea of becoming pure is that then the dust has a carrier. The dust, or the holy names of Krishna, which carry the dust of Krishna, being on different Krishna, his name, form, qualities, the dust, they're all identical. So this dust, which becoming in the form of the holy name, the idea is that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, we want to satisfy Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's desire and spread the holy name in every town and village of the world. Now the holy name has to have a vahan or a carrier. What's going to carry the holy name to every town and village of the world? And so the carrier of the holy name is the pure devotee's tongue. They will carry that name, which carries the saffron dust of Krishna's lotus feet, which immediately awakens everyone to Krishna consciousness. So this is why purity is emphasized so much. It's not so much for our purification, it's so we can carry the holy name and give to others. This is the main purpose of becoming purified. Then you can chant, carry the holy name wherever you go, you can speak the holy name, that dust will enter into their ears and hearts, and you then awaken to Krishna consciousness. So it's a pure devotee, he can carry that mahan, and therefore he can carry the holy name, the dust of Krishna, and therefore he knows how to please. Or Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is very pleased when he understands that the holy name is being spread in every town and village of the world. So this is the idea, we become pure so we can, by hearing the holy name, and then we can carry the holy name to Russia and wherever countries we belong to, and purify all the living entities. But they may receive these saffron dust particles from the lotus feet of Namadita. Dhammaduli ki
jai,
Daivo premanandi.
So we'll have a mechanical thing, but come from your heart, roll on the dust of this holy sand of Navadvip Dham. After this, we'll be taking prasadam.